All right, well, we're out here in the, with the truck. We got us a load of wood today. We're gonna have a bonfire tonight. So we need to split this up. So we're gonna take the old Jubilee here, get the finish mower off, and then we're gonna put this log splitter on. The boys are out here to help me. Right here. It's called a bark buster. And we're gonna get this hooked up and we'll show you how it works. Works off the 3-point hitch, so, and the PTO. So we'll get on that right now. All right, so we'll just remove this mower here. Disconnect a 3-point hitch, take the pins out of each side. And then take off the center link, and we pull off the PTO here, so. All right, so we got that thing off. This big old brush hog here. All right, I'm gonna hook this thing up to the 3-point hitch here. I'm hoping that this will hook up with this overrun on here. I'm not sure if it will, but we'll see here in a second. And if not, we may have to go over and get the old 8N or
pull that out
or take that off. I'm not sure yet, but it's like it might work. So get everything lined up here. Okay, so it turns out we do have to take off the overrun. The shaft is designed to go directly into the PTO without an overrun in the way. So, gotta remove the zerk fittings on both sides and knock the pin out. So, I'm working on that now. All right, so we'll knock the pin out here. 1/4-inch drive extension works pretty good on this. There's the pin coming out. Yep, it's out. Alright. Alright, so the pin's out and we pull that off. Now we should be able to get the PTO on, hopefully. If it's the right size, I guess we'll find out here in a second. Alright. PTO installed. Put the center link on. And then we'll be ready to go here. Okay, so we're all hooked up here, and as you can see, it's spinning. Now, these particular log splitters were all recalled back in the 80s when they were first made because they're very dangerous. As you can see, there's no way to shut this thing off unless you have somebody sitting right next to the PTO on-off. This thing does not turn off. If you had a long coat or a scarf or something that got caught in that thing right there, it won't stop. You have 26 horsepower or 28 horsepower pulling you right in. So what we've done, taken this string here, strung it up through here, and it goes right to the coil wire. So if anything happens, the operator here can grab that string and shut the engine right down. And as you can see, works just that quick. So we're going to leave that wired up. Even though there's going to be three of us out here, we still, just in case, we're going to have that wired up like that so that we can kill it instantly if we need to. Seems to work pretty well. So, just put it back on the coil here, and then we'll start back up, and then we'll start splitting some wood. So, all right, we're going to get to it. Take your logs and you stick them on this end here. You give it a little push and it pulls right through. So, give it a... All right, so we're going to try this log first. And stick it right on here. Yep, just like that. Nope. Sideways. Yep. Ram it up there until it gets caught. Then it'll start pulling itself in. say it's pretty dangerous. So, alright, so we need to knock these pieces out. There we go. Alright, let's try another one. Think of a way to shut it down. There it goes. See, it's pretty dangerous, but it works good. And there we go. Alright. And the old Ford Jubilee. For maybe half an hour. Look at this pile we've got going here. This thing does a really good job. You just have to be careful, that's all. Have a nice fire tonight, that's for sure. All right, thanks for watching.